Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvundi. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 10.3. The topic for today's discussion is Problems in the Clutch Design. In the earlier lecture also, we discussed the theory part of the clutch design and we solved a problem in the single plate clutch and the cold clutch. And in this lecture, we will be solving few problems on the multi-plate clutch under uniform pressure and wear conditions. And this is lecture number 10.3, example number 6. The question is from November 2011 question paper. So I discuss all the problem only from Anna University question paper so that it will help you to understand the level of questions in the Anna University. A multiple disc clutch consisting of steel and bronze plates is to transmit 10 kilowatt at 1000 rpm. The inner and the outer diameter of the disc being 90 and 160 millimeter respectively. The engagement factor may be taken as 1.25. The coefficient of friction between the contacting plates is 0.18. The maximum intensity of pressure is 0.3 newtons per millimeter square. Find the required number of steel and the bronze plates using uniform wear conditions. So we write down the given data. Power is 10,000 watts. It is given as 10 kilowatt, 10,000 watts. Speed equal to 1000 rpm. Inner radius is 0.45 meter. Outer radius capital R equal to 0.08 meter. Engagement factor is 1.25. Coefficient of friction is 0.18 and the intensity of pressure is 0.3 into 10 power 6 newtons per meter square. For uniform wear conditions, the mean radius for the friction disc, so Rm equal to capital R plus small r divided by 2. So 0.08 plus 0.045 divided by 2 equal to 0.0625 meter. And we calculate the torque transmitted by the clutch from the power given, power of clutch, we calculate the torque. Mt equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi N. So 10,000 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 1000 equal to 95.5 Newton meter. And we are given the engagement factor. So the design torque of the clutch Mt within bracket equal to the torque transmitted Mt into engagement factor, which is 95.5 into 1.25 equal to 119.4 Newton meter. Then the axial thrust to be provided for uniform wear theory. The formula is Q equal to 2 pi Pa into R into small r into capital R minus small r. So substituting numerical values, Q equal to 2 into 3.14 into 0.3 into 10 power 6 into 0.045 into 0.08 minus 0.045 equal to 2967.3 newtons per meter square. Then the torque transmitted per pair of frictional surfaces, Mt1. For one pair of frictional surfaces, mu into Q into Rm. So mu is the coefficient of friction, 0.18, Q is the axial force, 2967.3, and Rm is the mean radius, 0.0625. So calculating, it is 33.38 Newton meter. Then the number of pairs of frictional surfaces, Z equal to the design torque of the clutch divided by torque transmitted per pair of the clutch. So Z equal to design torque divided by torque per clutch. So 119.4 divided by 33.38 equal to 3.57. We make it as 4. So Z, number of pairs of frictional surface equal to 4. And number of plates equal to Z plus 1. So Z plus 1 equal to 4 plus 1 equal to 5. There are 5 plates in the clutch. So number of steel plates equal to 3 and number of bronze plate equal to 2. That is the answer to the problem. We have to calculate number of steel plates and number of bronze plates. The example number 7 from November 2009 question paper. A plate clutch has 3 discs on the driving shaft and 2 discs on the driven shaft, providing 4 pair of contact surfaces. The outside diameter of the contact surface is 240 mm and the inside diameter is 120 mm. Assuming uniform pressure and the coefficient of friction is 0.3, find the total spring load pressing the plates together to transmit 25 kilowatt at 1600 rpm. So we write down the given data. Z1, number of plates on the driving shaft, Z1 equal to 3. Z to number of plates on the driving shaft, driven shaft is 2. So Z equal to Z1 plus Z2 minus 1 equal to 4. There are 4 pair of contact surfaces. Inner outer radius is 0.12 meter and inner radius is 0.06 meter. Uniform pressure conditions we have to use. Mu equal to 0.3. The power transmitted is 25 kilowatt and the speed equal to 1600 rpm. The torque transmitted by the clutch MT from the power given, MT equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi n. So 25,000 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 1600 equal to 149.3 newton meter. So the torque transmitted by the clutch equal to 149.3 newton meter. And the torque transmitted by a pair of frictional surfaces. So MT bracket 1. So for one pair, total torque transmitted by the clutch divided by number of pairs of frictional surfaces. So MT divided by Z equal to 149.3 divided by 4 equal to 37.325 newton meter. So the torque transmitted by a pair of frictional surface equal to 37.325 meter. Then for uniform pressure conditions, we have to calculate the mean radius. So Rm equal to 2 by 3 into R to the power 3, capital R to the power 3 minus small r to the power 3 divided by capital R square minus small r square. So substituting numerical values, 2 by 3 into 0.12 to the power 3 minus 0.06 to the power 3 divided by 0.12 square minus 0.06 square equal to 0.0933 meter. Then the spring force required acting on the clutch plate, Q equal to MT1 divided by mu into Rm. So 37.325 divided by 0.3 into 0.0933 equal to 1333.5 newton. The spring force are the force acting on the clutch surface, clutch plate is 1333.5 newton. So the answer to the question, the total spring force acting on the clutch plate Q equal to 1333.5 newton. The example number 8 from May 2008 question paper, a multi-disc clutch consists of 5 steel plates and 4 bronze plates. The inner and the outer diameter of the friction disc are 75 mm and 150 mm respectively. The coefficient of friction is 0.1. The intensity of pressure is limited to 0.3 newtons per millimeter square. Assuming uniform wear theory, calculate the required operating force and the power transmitting capacity at the 750 rpm. So we write down the given data, Z1 equal to 5 and Z2 equal to 4. The inner radius is 0.0375 meter, outer radius is 0.075 meter, coefficient of friction mu equal to 0.1, the pressure is 0.3 newtons per millimeter square and the speed is 750 rpm. For uniform wear conditions, the mean radius we have to calculate. Rm equal to capital R plus small r divided by 2. So 0.075 plus 0.0375 divided by 2 equal to 0.05625 meter. Then the axial thrust or the axial force provided for uniform wear theory. So Q equal to 2 pi Pa into R into capital R minus small r. So substituting numerical values, 2 into 3.14 into 0.3 into 10 power 6 into 0.0375 into 0.075 minus 0.0375 equal to 2649.4 newtons per meter square. Then the torque transmitted per pair of frictional surfaces, MT1 equal to mu into Q into Rm. So 0.1 into 2649.4 into 0.05625 equal to 14.9 newton meter. Number of pairs of frictional surfaces, Z equal to Z1 plus Z2 minus 1. So 5 plus 4 minus 1 equal to 8. And the total torque transmitted by the clutch, Z into torque transmitted per pair of frictional surfaces, 8 into 14.9 equal to 119.2 newton meter. So the power transmitting capacity of the clutch, P equal to 2 pi n into MT divided by 60. So 2 into 3.14 into 750 into 119.2 divided by 60 equal to 9357 watts or 9.357 kilowatt. That is the answer to the problem. So the operating force Q equal to 2649.4 newton and the power transmitting capacity of the clutch equal to 9.36 kilowatts. Example number 9, it was appearing in 3 question papers, November 2005, November 2012 and May 2014. A hydraulically operated clutch is to be designed for an automatically operated lathe. Determine the number of plates and the operating force required for a clutch which is to transmit a torsional moment of 35 Newton meter under normal operating conditions. The clutch is to be designed to slip under 300% of the rated torsional moment to protect the gears and other parts of the drive. The limit for the diameter of the frictional surface due to the space limitations are 100 mm and 62.5 mm. The clutch is to operate in an oily atmosphere. So we write down the given data. MT, the torque transmitted is 35 Newton meter. The slip is 300%. Outer radius is 0.05 meter and inner radius is 0.03125 meter. So we are given diameter, we have to calculate the radius. For uniform wear conditions, oily atmosphere. So it is given as oily atmosphere. For oily atmosphere, we have to consider, we have to use the uniform wear conditions, the mean radius. So RM equal to capital R plus small r divided by 2. So 0.05 plus 0.03125 divided by 2 equal to 0.040625. meter. Then allowable pressure for the steel plate. So the value is not given. We have to refer to the data book, page number 7.89. PH data book, page number 7.89. The PA, the allowable pressure is 6 kg force per centimeter square, which is 6 into 10 power 5 newtons per meter square. And we have to assume the coefficient of friction. It is also not given. We assume 0.25, mu equal to 0.25. So the axial thrust to be provided for uniform wear theory, Q equal to 2 pi Pa into R into capital R minus small r. So substituting the numerical values, 2 into 3.14 into 6 into 10 power 5 into 0.03125 into 0.05 minus 0.03125 equal to 2207.8 newtons per meter square. So the torque transmitted per para frictional surfaces, MT1 equal to mu into Q into RM. So substituting 0.25 into 2207.8 into 0.040625 equal to 22.42 Newton meter. Then the design torque equal to MT into 300% slip. So we have to multiply the torque by 3. So 3 into MT equal to 3 into 35 equal to 105 Newton meter. Then the number of pairs of frictional surfaces is equal to design torque of the clutch divided by torque transmitted per pair of the clutch. So design torque equal to 105. And the torque transmitted per pair of clutch, we have calculated as 22.42 is equal to 4.68 equal to 5. So number of pairs of frictional surface equal to 5. So number of plates equal to Z plus 1, 5 plus 1 equal to 6. So the answer to the problem, number of plates equal to 6 and operating force required is 2207.8 Newton. And we stop here. These are all the books I published in mechanical engineering. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comment box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture on the subject design of transmission system. Until then, bye.